Sounds like such a great candidate, doesn't he? I think I'll support him for president, but not of this country, maybe Venezuela. You have the Bernie Bolsheviks now who are backing Biden. Bernie Sanders basically is running the Democrat Party. This is the Bernie Sanders agenda. Joe Biden is an empty suit. He's surrounded himself with every radical kook you can imagine, like AOC and others. This is a Democrat Party that is as evil as it's ever been. It's a growing anti-Semitic movement within the Democrat Party. It is a growing anti-America movement at its core. Joe Biden's been around for half a century. He's been in Washington, D.C. for half a century. So for him to talk about, we're going to make fundamental economic changes, we're going to make changes and make the country more equal. He spent a good portion of his career in the United States Senate as a bigot. And I mean this in all seriousness. If you look at his background and the things that he used to say, Joe Biden was a nasty, mean man. He destroyed Bob Bork, or tried to. Talk to his family. He tried to destroy Clarence Thomas. Talk to his family. This isn't some lunch bucket, Joe. This guy is a fraud. Meanwhile, he's got his Senate records. They're all hiding in the University of Delaware. They want to talk about Trump's taxes. If you don't mind, I want to hit the United States Supreme Court briefly here. It's very, very important. We have two justices on the Supreme Court and seven politicians. That's what we have. The Roberts Court is a disaster. It's rudderless. You've got the four horses of liberalism there who vote together on the big issues every time, and they hope to flip Roberts or Kavanaugh and Gorsuch, and they're doing a hell of a good job of it. I want the American people to know today that five lawyers in Roves, picked from obscurity today, ruled that half of Oklahoma doesn't belong to Oklahoma anymore. It belongs to an Indian tribe. You have a couple of million American citizens now, apart from Native Americans, who live in that part of the state, and they have no idea what their fate is. This is a court that is tyrannical. This is a court that has done more damage to the rule of law and the Constitution than to the Bernie Sanders-Biden rioters over the last 2 months on a number of cases. And let's talk about the president's tax returns. What the hell is it about his tax returns that they're obsessed with? Is there something wrong with his tax returns? No. What's going on? His tax returns are probably like this, and then you take the attachments, they're probably like this, and we know what the media and the Democrats will do. Oh, he took a deduction for this. He shouldn't have taken a deduction for this. These are evil people. That's why I think the president doesn't want to give his tax returns. And the Supreme Court just issued a decision that allows every podunk prosecutor to come up with a pretext and to get a president's tax returns or financial information. What the hell is that all about? They're destroying the executive branch. Then we have Congress. They have subpoenas. We need to know about the finances of the president. They didn't want to know the finances about Obama or Clinton or Biden when he was vice president. No, this president. You want to know why? Because this is one of the first presidents we ever had who actually earned money before he became president of the United States. All the rest of them, the Obamas, Biden, Gore, they become multimillionaires selling their prior offices. This man gives up his salary to charity and so forth. Legislative oversight. Congress has legislative oversight. They don't investigate a president's finances. They don't issue tons of subpoenas. The Supreme Court did grave damage to the Constitution today, and they're supposed to uphold the Constitution. The tax issue, the supremacy clause, Sam Alito is 100% right. That is, a prosecutor for a county doesn't have the power to get the president's tax returns. He can't indict a president. So what the hell does he want them for? You know what the pretext he used is, Sean?
Mark.
Hush money. Since when is a non-disclosure agreement hush money?
Mark.
Corporations enter into non-disclosure agreements. Politicians enter into non-disclosure agreements. I'd like to know how many non-disclosure agreements there are in the Cyrus Vance District Attorney's Office, in the Southern District of New York office, members of Congress. That's not hush money. That's not a campaign violation. The Southern District of New York dropped that a long time ago. So the Supreme Court goes along with this? And these endless subpoenas from Congress, the Democrats, they've impeached the president once, an unconstitutional impeachment. They're threatening to impeach the Attorney General of the United States. They have cavorted with lawlessness in the Obama administration that attempted a coup. You know, the president of the United States, you know, he must wonder if they're all out to get him. They are all out to get him. And let me tell you one other thing. You talk about how important this election is and Joe Biden and what he stands for. I don't give a damn about Joe Biden and what he stands for. He sucked this country dry. He's made himself rich. He's been in public office for his entire life. I care about the American people. This election is between the American people who love this country, who believe in 1776, who believe in the founders, who believe in Jefferson, Washington, Benjamin Franklin, John Adams, and all the rest, and those who do not. Joe Biden hasn't defended the cops in this country once. He hasn't denounced the rioters other than one barely coherent sentence, other than once. Nancy Pelosi has never condemned the rioters. Schumer has never condemned the rioters. You want to know why? They're Democrats. They're Bernie Sanders supporters. So the people who love this country, I don't give a damn what party you are, or if you have no party, if you're working hard, if you're trying to work hard, if you want the economy open, if you want your kids to go back to school, if you want to have some normalcy back, you got to vote for Trump. I know what the narrative is. Trump won't unite us. How is he supposed to unite us with rioters? How is he supposed to unite us with Nancy Pelosi and Joe Biden and that party? The Democrat Party has a history of anti-Americanism. Whether it's slavery, segregation, Jim Crow, it has a history of anti-Americanism, and that includes today. It's just a different ism. It was the Confederacy then. Now they're dancing with the Marxists. Whether it's Black Lives Matter or Antifa, whether it's the mayor of New York, DeCamio, and now they've embraced Bernie Sanders, the most radical man or woman, but the most radical person in Congress today. That is now the Biden agenda. If you're a union person and a Democrat, if you're a non-union person and a Democrat, you better wake up to what's going on. These are not old-style Democrats anymore. These are crazy bastards. Yes, Sean.
Okay, well, that's a good way to end it. I will say this, you know, if Donald Trump said the things that Pelosi, Schumer, praising, you know, the former Klansman, or Biden's positions, his comments about a racial jungle or predators, or his positions on integration, busing, segregation, praising segregation. These are modern Democrats. That's Schumer, Pelosi, Biden, Hillary, and Bill. Great one. I got to let you go. Thank you for being with us, sir. Joining us now on the phone is...